Google has a new admin panel for managing your organization's services. These can include Google Apps or other enterprise products like Maps Coordinate, Chrome devices, and more. Here, you can do everything you've done in the past using the classic admin panel, only now your panel has a cleaner look, it's easier to navigate, and you can customize it for your typical workflow. Let's take a look at what's new. You sign in to the new admin panel as you always have, using your administrator name and password. Only now, your dashboard has individual controls for managing users and groups, your products and services, and all other aspects of your account. If you like, you can drag controls around to rearrange them. Click here to add more controls, and hide any controls you don't need. In just a few clicks, you can build the perfect dashboard for tasks you perform most often. Also on your dashboard, you can go here to see announcements and alerts, keep tabs on how many people are using your services, and find other useful tools and shortcuts too. Now, to access specific settings, click Controls on the dashboard. Most settings are organized a lot like they were in the classic panel and should be pretty easy to find. We've also made some new logical groupings. Under Company Profile, for example, you'll find settings for changing your default time zone, uploading your company logo, and otherwise tailoring things for your organization. When you're done in one area, you can use this menu to open another dashboard control, say to manage your domains or your admin roles, or click the back arrow to go up a level, here returning to the dashboard. To manage your company's user accounts, click the Users control. This takes you to a page listing all your users, much like in your classic admin panel, only now you can choose what to show in each column, and you can scroll through all your users at once, no matter how many of them you have. Go ahead and add new users by clicking here. And if you're looking for any organizational units where you've given different users access to different apps, click the Filters icon here, then click an org to see its users. Or build out your org structure by opening these menus over here. Back in the user list, you can select one or more users to then see controls for adding them all at once to a group, to another organization, or even to a brand new org you create right now. Of course, you can click a user to manage her account, say to change her password, or to list her apps. Then go up here to quickly switch to another user. And if you're looking for something you don't see at first, like maybe his admin roles, try clicking Show More. Okay, so now let's look at managing your service settings. To do this, we'll head back to the dashboard and find the product you want to manage. For example, if you're looking for your Gmail or calendar settings, click Google Apps, which shows, well, all your Google Apps. Here, you can see which apps are enabled. You can turn apps on or off. And again, if you've grouped users in organizations, open filters to enable apps for each org. Click an individual app to see its basic usage, then drill down to change its settings. These are the same settings you managed in the classic admin panel. When you're done managing one app, you can quickly jump to another, or go back up a level to see the entire list again. Click here to add more business features for users. And finally, don't forget all the great free services that come with your account, which you'll find in other Google services, like Google Analytics, or one of my favorites, Google Plus. We hope you like the new admin panel, And if you have a question while you're working in it, click the question mark and type what you're looking for. Or for even more help, say to contact someone directly, you got it. Click the support control.